हेलो एंड वेलकम एवरीवन टू द डे टू ऑफ द नवरात्रि सीरीज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय थिंग जीसीटी इन कोलैबोरेशन विद क्रिएटिव कलाकार। थिंग जीसीटी इज अ सोशल एंटरप्राइज व्हिच वर्क्स विद 1000 प्लस आर्टिसंस ओवर 19 लोकेशंस इन इंडिया टू क्रिएट हैंडक्राफ्टेड गिफ्ट्स एंड हैंड डेकोर्स। इको फ्रेंडली दे यूज इको फ्रेंडली मटेरियल्स टू क्रिएट ऑल दीज गिफ्ट एंड होम डेकोर एंड वी एट क्रिएटिव कलाकार ऑर्गेनाइज ऑनलाइन वर्कशॉप फॉर हेरिटेज आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट ऑल अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड। सो स्टार्टिंग आर डे टू इट टूडे विल बी लर्निंग आइपन आर्ट। आइपन आर्ट इज अ रिचुअलिस्टिक फोक आर्ट नेटिव टू द कुमायन रीजन ऑफ उत्तराखंड। इट इज ड्रॉन टू सेलिब्रेट ऑस्पिशियस ओकेजन्स फेस्टिवल्स एंड रिचुअल्स। It is said that this art form is known to offer protection against evil. And what better occasion than Navratri to do this art form? So the history of Aipan goes this way. It was flourished during the rule of Chan dynasty in Kumaon region. And it was originated in Alamora and slowly found its way all across the state of Uttarakhand. Traditionally, Aipan is done on a smooth surface, which is prepared using wet ochre mud known as geru, and that is red in color. And to paint it, a white paste is made by grounding cooked rice in water known as biswas to create patterns on the surface. The women of Uttarakhand are known to practice this, and it has been passing through generations. The motifs and designs are inspired by religious beliefs of the community and the natural resources around them. They generally include shells, creepers, floral patterns, swastika, footsteps of goddesses, geometric designs, figures of god and goddesses. And today we'll be learning the art Aipan and we'll be drawing goddess Durga. So, telling you more about Aipan. The linear lines drawn in Aipan are symbolic to the rituals or the festivals they are drawn for. So we'll start with our session. So for today. So for today, we'll be requiring a red sheet, a white pen, and a white pencil. So we'll start by creating the outline. So starting from the center bottom, we create a semicircle, a half semicircle. And we continue this pattern further. So Aipan is said to protect against evil, and so is Navratri, where goddess the Nav Durga protects us from all our evils, fighting our demons. Now we create some small figures, circular figures inside. Traditionally, this was done only on walls, but now, due to the modern requirements, these are done on various surfaces. These designs are done on various surfaces. Going further, we'll continue the semicircular pattern or the curves.
and we'll give some decoration too.
So the pattern that we're doing today of IPIN is almost symmetric. So if you aren't comfortable drawing freehand, you can divide your page into half and work on it. As you can see, what the designs that I'm doing on my left are the same designs that I'm doing on my right. So all these motifs, as you can see, are either geometric like circles, or the one that I'm doing now is kind of a floral pattern. So like I said, all these are derived from nature. The white on the red highlights and gives the more highlights the whole drawing. This is also, if you notice, these are also the paintings or drawings that you see when you are, when you do a rangoli or any painting style during a puja. So we practice this in modern times too. So now we'll be creating the face of Ma Durga. Very intricate patterns are used in this. So yesterday we did the same we did a Ma Durga painting using the mandala, a Ma Durga mandala. In case you missed, you can watch out the Facebook space or visit the YouTube channel of Creative Kalakar. So here we have the outline for Ma Durga. Similarly, what pattern I am making now, you can resemble it to something like a leaf.
these Ipan paintings are really beautiful, beautiful paintings. After they're completed, they look really very beautiful and stunning, and they are really eye pleasing too. So as you can see, the level of intricacy that is going inside this. Over the course of this 9 days of Navratri, we'll be doing more such Indian art forms. For yesterday, we did mandala. Today we are doing Ipan. You can watch out our Facebook space for more details of what is going to come tomorrow. So following the symmetry, as you can see, as the painting is coming into life, how it beautifies the whole page. Now we'll work on the mukut. Very fine and small circles. It is preferred to do it freehand because traditionally these paintings, when done on floor surfaces or any other surfaces, they are done using fingertips. So it is preferred, if you are doing it on a sheet of paper, you do it freehand. Now we'll give the details to Ma Durga's face, starting with the mouth. Giving her a nod. A gorgeous and beautiful eyes. It is always recommended that if you're doing it on a sheet of paper, you keep a white pencil with you so that all the coloring parts can be done very easily. Finally, giving her a bindi. Working on a beautiful mukut. giving a little adding a little jewels in a mukut to glorify it. So you can just do a rain, draw a raindrop shape. Now, giving some floral curvy patterns. To give the mukut a rich feel. And lastly, the main crown. Petal patterns. You can even add some double circles here. And since it's symmetrical, same on the other side. We'll give some strokes here so as to give a spiral look to it. So these all are optional. But they enhance the painting even more. So here we are done with the outline of the painting, outline of the icon, as you can see here. Now we'll work on the coloring. So for coloring, you are required to use a white pencil, preferably Apsara glass white pencil. So we'll start. If you require somewhere, you can give a double highlight border. So we'll be coloring in between these circles so as to give a jewelry look. Same way on the other side. So these pencils aren't dark enough, but they give the exact same feel and are easier. So So even the pendant of the necklace will color the circles of the pendant of necklace. Further, will color these will highlight Ma's face a little by coloring little ex some extra edges. Okay. Next, we'll color the eyeballs. So as you can see how it glorifies the whole painting. We'll highlight some of these areas. And color her eyebrows. Next up, we will color the bindi, the main bindi, the bigger one. And here, we'll highlight a few portions. And color the in outer portions of the double circles. Outer edges of the double circles. Back again. We'll color these small circles out here. Similarly, on the other side. We'll even color these circles inside this spiral stroke. And the floral pattern. Similarly, on the symmetric side, you can see how the painting is coming to life with just two colors, that is red and white. Next up, we'll color the earring, outer portion of the earring. and will color the open edges of the leaf. Open edges of the leaf so that it can give a very beautiful highlight. So by open edges, I mean these portions where it is open out here. Similarly, we'll color the second portion out here. And also on the symmetric side. So not only IPAN, all the Indian art forms are very beautiful to watch and to learn. And we at Creative Kalakar take online classes for all these artworks. So now we'll color her hairs. You can even watch tutorial videos or watch a few videos on our YouTube channel. And also this festive season for gifting options, if you go vocal for local and for best eco-friendly handmade products, you can contact things, etc. So we'll color in between the circles too, so that all the portion of our hair is colored properly. Now, for the next part, once our hair is done, we'll go for the crown. In the crown, we'll color the outer portions of the jewels. Not the gems, but the outer portion. Carefully, we'll color all the areas. The complete area. And we'll just give some extra highlight to the floral patterns in the mukut, in the crown. and also the petal patterns. So if you're practicing, do notice how the extra highlight with a white pencil can bring a change to the whole painting. Lastly, for the jewel, for the jewel or the tip of the crown, we'll color the outermost droplet. And the innermost droplet. Also, if you wish to color the gem of the nut, you can. So, this is our icon painting. This is our complete icon painting, as you can see, of how we started with just an outline and how it has beautified. So, that's it for the day. Keep watching this the Facebook page of Things ECT, Instagram page of Things ECT, and Creative Kalakar. You can follow us on our YouTube channels and you can subscribe our YouTube channels and follow our Instagram pages. That's it. Today's IPIN. We'll meet tomorrow with a new art form. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today. Thank you.